dumelang le kae lebetso la ka ke tsulani yeye Gumede ngitamukele with the week ahead with me ishow yethu ngempela edlenge impact you know edlenge impact kakhulu you know the aim is to impact impilo zabantu and impact again kwimpilo zabantu lezo mpilo ziyakwazi ukubuya back zizo impacta nathi I think yona into efika ibe namandla le ukuthi ukuhamba ugqugquzela noma wenza izinto ezisenhlizweni yakho zinendlela yokuthi firstly zenze lokho uNkulunkulu asuke kubeka enhlizweni yakho khona lapho futhi unganakile uyithole usuqhuquzeleka kwayiwena you know I think yona into engithanda kakhulu lengalokho as much as singaqali sinezinhloso zokuthi uqala kwethu ukuthi sisuke sifuna ukuthi siqhuquzeleke directly but we do this because it is in our hearts you know and ubona kanjani ukuthi into isenhlizweni yakho kwesinye isikhathi ubona nje nge reaction inhliziyo yakho noma i feeling oyitholayo uma kuba khona osizakalayo you know that's I think is amazing you know ukuthi ugqugquzeleka kwabantu kuyakwazi ukukunikeza ipeace and you get to realize ukuthi azukuthi I can live on this you know ngingaqhubeka ngikwenze lokho at times ngisho futhi kubuye ngathi akho umuntu ogqugquzelekayo uNkulunkulu uyakubeka lokho nasenhlizweni ukuthi sibe naye understanding ukuthi some of the things sizikhuluma manje nesizenza manje zizo impact abantu mhlawumbe 20 years from now banye 50 years from now but leyo nto nje ubuhlala kwileni yakho ube nakho ukuthi lokho ngizokwenza regardless of whether ama fruits ungabona manje noma ngiwabona 20 years from now but ukwazi ukuthi one day okwenzayo kuzokwazi ukuthi kwenza umehluko so siyabonga kakhulu ke bengithi ngishaye intro lapho last week we started e session lapho bengihamba khona Nompilo Nompilo Gumede unkosikazi wami ebesikhuluma khona about uNkulunkulu ku workplace uNkulunkulu noma ukubona amandla kaNkulunkulu eyindaweni esisuke sisebenzela kuzo namanje njengoba ngangithembisile impela ukuthi ngabona kunesidingo ukuthi sibe naye futhi sesijini esibili you know so namhlanje nginaye impela and from next week kuyaphambili ngoba sobe sesingena June I think uJune nje ngizofisa sibe nokugxila ecubunguleni noma ekudingideni izinto ze fatherhood I'll also have guests I think I will do one or two sessions by myself but ngizozama ukuthi ngibe nabantu futhi esobe sixoxisana nabo kule zinto zokuba ze fathering so ngale nje ukuthi size sishaye isikhathi sithile ngithi angibingelela uMpilo la ngoba ngifuna siqhubeke nale session engicabanga ukuthi yayi powerful kakhulu ngiyathemba nawe wayithokozele impela and uma unga ukuthi mhlawumbe anikonnecta ngakahle nayo isejini trust me sizofika isikhathi la uzobuyela back khona ngoba mhlawumbe usukwa through some of the things esasikhuluma ngazo I know this for a fact in fact let me share on this briefly I wrote incwadi inqaba Griffin Hope you know book that was well received and there were people I understand who couldn't stomach the book because at that time they had never experienced anything that was covered in the book but we've seen a lot of people coming back you know to buy that book and I'm wondering how balo muntu lona sekuphele 5 years azi ngale ncwadi why sezoyidinga manje desperately ebese uya realize ukuthi no now they are going through what you covered in the book so I think this is for someone as well who's out there trying to impact and challenge people ukuthi again into yenzayo there will come a time abanye labazoyifila khona ukuthi bayayidinga it's not for everyone you know but at times we wish whatever that we share kungaba ukuthi abantu babe ne understanding ukuthi bayihlomise ngayo lento eli so yeah that's all Mpilo welcome to the week ahead with me. And kuhamba kanjani?
Hayi, kuhamba kahle kakhulu. Ngiyajabula kakhulu ukuthi uphinde ungibize ngibe ingxenye yohlelo lakho.
Nice, ngiphinde ngikubize. Hayi, siyabonga, siyabonga. Ehhe, kuhamba kanjani nje empilweni-ke nje, sesibuka impilo nje as a whole, holistically. Is everything fine, Isonto, from the other episode to now? What is changing, and what is it that you feel you are learning, you know?
Tulani, I had an opportunity izolo yokumenywa as a guest speaker emcimbini ka Thenjiwe Zulu be celebrator uNkulunkulu ukuthi uhambe naye, but into engihlabe umxhole kakhulu ubize abantu abahlukumezekile.
Yeah.
Hey, ngifunde a lot about abuse in that event.
Sure.
Ukuthi abantu bayadlula ey'khathini ey'nzima kodwa bangafuni ukutshela abanye just because bafuna kubonakala sengathi impilo yabo i-right. Mina-ke ngibe sengi-related to le yasemsebenzini ukuthi sometimes now we are told ucabanga ukuthi hawu mhlampe mina engingenzi kahle ingakho mhlampe ngihlupheka, kodwa abantu ladies ate laphaya they were sharing about relationships kakhulu. Bekukhuluma iy'ndaba zokuhlala ne-narcissist, ngifunde elikhulu. Bekukhuluma iy'ndaba zokuthi abanye they've stayed more than 10 years kuma-relationship kodwa bebesaba ukuthi uma betshela abantu bazobajaja abantu, yabo.
Yeah.
So into engiyifundile nje engihlaba umxhwele ukuthi uma kuthi ukukhona lapho abuseka khona, speak up, khuluma, thola umuntu ozokhuluma naye. Because sometimes more abuser umuntu ukwenza in a nice way, yabo. Akhulume kahle.
Yeah.
Omunye futhi akakushaya nokukushaya.
Yeah.
Omunye nje ulwa nokuthi uyakhuluma, abuse emotionally, akuqeda amandla. Athi hawu wena uzibona ukuthi umuhle yini, ayifanele lento. Kukhona omunye kade ekhuluma izwelo uthile xa bachaza ukuthi ena omunye umuntu uhamba esitolo ufuna ukuthenga enye into, ubuye uthenge enye, ubuye ubuze uyibuza ukuthi hayi bo ngiyithenge kanjani lento ngoba bengingayifuni. It's because usebenza ingqondo yakho, emotional abuse. So wonke lama types of abuses akhona ekhaya futhi akhona nasemsebenzini. So kufuneke sibe aware, sifundise, sizame ukuthi sikwazi ukuspot a person ofuna ukuk-abuse. Kwesinye isikhathi ngisho kuma friendships kuya-abuse-wana. And kuwa wonke ama-relationship, it's okay to say no. You don't have time to do this and you don't feel well in doing this. You can ask if the task can be submitted later or the next day.
Yeah.
Ngikhumbula ngelinye ilanga ngangicela ukuthi siye kwenye i-event and you said, Nompilo, I don't feel well going to that event. I actually appreciated that. I could have continued abusing it. No, yeah, ngenkani ngiyafuna uhambe nami, yabo. So sometimes we express awareness as a person ukuthi udinga ini. Ube honest, ube authentic. Because I believe in relationships, we should be authentic. Kanti ngabe sidlala ngesikhathi sethu masingabikho authentic.
Yeah, angisayikhumbuli event. Mhlawumbe ngingafuni ukuyosayina ama-autographs and stuff.
We pray.
Yeah, but just on that, Mpilo, I think you've touched on something close to my heart. Because izinkinga ey'ningi esinazo mfethu. Kwesinye isikhathi we exacerbate those problems esinganakile. Right now, mfethu, I want you to comment on this. Right now, I know close to 95% of females who have written books after their divorce or their marriage that didn't work well, you know. 95% of the people I know, I'm saying 95 because I'm just leaving that gap for each chance. 95% of the people who are writing books about their marriage are women, you know. And that on its own can easily convince someone ukuthi kulo 95% wama relationships men, because these stories are written by women. Bathi bahlakaniphile umlando umuxoxwa yibhubesi noma umlando umuxoxwa umzingeli uyohleze hlakaniphile noma futhi ekhaliphile uma eqhathanisa nebhubesi. Ngisho esitorini noma kwi-event la ibhubesi limnqobile lamenza kwenzakala into ethile wadlubuluntela, uzokwazi ukusichaza leso story as if ibhubesi ilona belingekho powerful, you know. All I'm trying to say, what can you say about situations? You remember futhi I commented when you event engangimenywe kuyo ukuthi ngiyokhuluma. Where I had to speak ukuthi as this is beautiful that women are coming out to speak, you know. But what can we do to ensure ukuthi we also speak to a man, you know? Because uma sizoba nabantu besifazana sharing their pain, sharing their struggles, it end up painting a picture as if women are the only ones going through things. I am not trying to downplay ama abuse eitori ezenzakalayo, but I'm just trying to say ukuthi I'm not putting a challenge futhi kubantu besifazane, but I am futhi on the other hand, because they are also raising sons, you know. They will have a temptation to focus kwi girl child ukuthi yazi ukuthini, be careful of this and that and that. Ngiyakhumbula ngeke ngafonelwa umunye usisi efuna ngiyokhuluma umsakazweni, angizumchaza, you know, efuna ngiyokhuluma okhosini. And this lady, indlela ayithuke ngakhona, she was asking me to speak on a certain particular topic, but useyangitshena ukuthi ngendlela asaba ngakhona abantu besifazane, the way she's so protective of ubhuti wakhe, because she's aware ukuthi how girls can manipulate you as a boy and ubakushaye bakuqede and all that, you know. I'm not trying to downplay, no, but it becomes a challenge when every Thursday women are meeting, every other day women are meeting, and they're discussing izinto emayelana nabo, and then a man does not even do anything to have ama events azokhuluma naye. I'm not saying ukuthi ku wrong for abantu besifazane ukuthi benze lokho. Maybe I'm challenging us as men ukuthi what is it that we can do as men now to have ama conversations azokhuluma nathi, and for women as well ukuthi as they have these conversations babe nakho in mind ukuthi yazi ukuthini, we're not gonna fix this country by fixing women, because we believe ukuthi women are not the only problem. So uma kuzofocus ukuthi every event, it's an event ekhuluma ngabantu besifazane ABCD, we need to try and push our husbands as well and to have these events. Let's talk to the churches, let them have more events. Let's speak to people who are authors. Let us encourage them to have events. Ukuthi talk to men. The more we talk to men, I'm sure we'll get to a place where we'll have ama events azohlanganisa a man and a female, and a man and a woman, and kube conversations azokwazi ukuthi asimove esephambili. Because right now, just speaking holistically, not pointing out at anything, I feel we are not going to be solving problems by focusing on one particular, unless we are convinced ukuthi men are the only problem in these relationships or whatever. I'm rambling right now, but I hope you get the point. You are raising boys right now.
Yes.
That puts you in a position to make sure ukuthi whatever damage that may be in kulabo bantu besilisa abakhulile, you make sure ukuthi you groom them. Bakhule babe ileyonto engeke zibe abusive.
Ezokwazi ukuhlonipha abantu besifazane.
Ihlonipha abantu besifazane. And also kulabo abakhulisa amantombazane babe nakho lokho futhi. Uyenza kanjani indoda, wenze njani kwi relationship ukuthi ungamlimazi umuntu wesilisa?
You know, izolo I know ukuthi the ladies abasikhona mhlawumbe bathintekile, ngikhuluma ngokuthi we as women fight with our words, so we must mind our tongue.
Sure.
As we move on.
That's powerful. That's powerful.
So cause nathi sigcina sisoffend abantu ngento esishoyo, you know. So kubalulekile, and I think the beginning of my speech actually said ukuthi the most important relationship we'll ever have is a relationship with God. I believe ukuthi umuntu i relationship yakhe noNkulunkulu mayi right ngeke agcine efike emazweni azolimaza omunye umuntu as well.
Yeah.
Sideways, both the male having a good relationship with God and a female having a good relationship with God.
Yeah.
And yes, when I attend these women events ngiyacabanga ukuthi who is out there influencing my boys? Who is out there taking care of the men?
Yeah.
And as you know, I'm planning an event that will include both the men and the women.
Yeah.
And on the 10th of September, just keep watching the space,
you know, definitely.
So that we can have these conversations, the hard ones, on why do you males do this to us? And then the males can answer for themselves.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and what I've learned in my journey to learning in the workplace is it's important to develop yourself outside of work. you don't just need to do what your employer wants.
Sure.
Those are my lessons. Yeah. Ukuthi awenze degree just because izokusiza to get to the next step in your employer.
Sure, that's powerful.
Yeah, there are other things as ukufuna ukuyifunda. Yabo nje last year khona ikhoze ngayijoyina ye social media, ngay apply la mina eceleni. And even now I'm attending a career acceleration program with Coach Vumile Msweli because I see ukuthi noma inkampani ingangikhokhela kuloko imina engidinga ukudevelop.
Yeah.
I need to develop my communication skills. I need to develop my side hustle as well. I need to develop khona izinto engizaziyo ukuthi mina kufanele ngidevelop because angifuni ukuhlala in one company ngisho ngingasafuni just because mina ngiyidevelophanga.
Yeah.
Bese ngiblame abantu.
Just on that mfethu. Ngeke ngabona kakhulu lento and ngiyibuke kumina futhi ukuthi ngisaka kakhulu ngifike ngiphuma esikoleni. Enye one of the challenges elimaza abantu abaningi engicabanga ukuthi namanje isabalimaza abanye ile ndaba ukuthi ubuke success ngomuntu reporter kuyena yabo because uyayihalela leya position and in your mind you are thinking impumelelo yami izoncike ekutheni one day ngizobe ngihleli kulesa sihlalo only to find ukuthi uNkulunkulu has called you kwezinye indawo mfethu you know and as in fact I had to change my positions kabili. Kwenye indawo, I think I did it once. I remember moving from one department to another. And by so doing, mfethu, I remember coming back in your vakasha, the department and closing 7 again. And I was so surprised, mfethu, taibu. Yabo, I thought success yami izoba ngokumove kulama division. And now, I'm coming back, mfethu. And sengachive kakhulu by just moving slightly. Yabo. And ngibuka izinto esengizenza, ngibuka izinto, even salary wise, I'm like, kube ngiselapha even if futhi angitholile le position bengeke ngibe kule state enguso right now.
Exactly.
You know, so at times we can be fixated to think ukuthi you know and lento isilimaza futhi ngoba kwesinye isikhathi uzothi yafunda umphathi wakho uthola ukuthi I qualification anayo kwaba ukuthi mhlambe wenzelelwa noma wafike wasebenza. So umuntu uyafunda that I know ufundelana because buka mina ngila you know.
Yeah.
So the thing yokwazi ukuthi success yami but I thank God for inkampani engisebenzelayo but success yami uNkulunkulu angayisebenzisa ngale organization but there could be a place going in down.
Exactly.
You know.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
And another thing engiyibona invaluable in my lessons when I saw God in the workplace, don't expect validation from other people.
Sure.
All the time.
Yeah.
Because sometimes abanye bethu bafuna ukuphampa njengeprimer stove ukuthi I won't move to the next level. Ngisebenza kangaka kodwa bangiboni. If you know you're doing your best, like there's nothing engafuneki kuhlupe.
And there's a reason why people do that.
Mm.
You know, there's a reason why people do that.
Or bengakuncomi.
No, no, no. There's a reason why people will seek validation. You know, we may need to scratch the surface and get there, you know. Kono into yasho uthi DJX uthi I remember way back uthi mafuna umuntu ozomnqumela utshane ucela umuntu ozofika anquma utshane angalodi ufuna ukuphampa ukuthi hey yazi ubunquma kahle utshane kanjani kanjani. If you are called to cut the grass, come and cut the grass and leave as soon as you're done, you know. But it's easy to say that uma sicubungula mfethu abantu balimela, you know. You know, I mean, you have people who are growing up without fathers,
yeah,
who are lacking affirmation, you know. You have people in fact who abaphuma kuma divisions la mfethu yonke into bebeyenza bengazothi ayinasi isidingo. So they are seeking that thing.
Yabo.
They are seeking it. Yes, akukho right ukuthi abantu bayafuna ukusebenza ngokuseeka ama validation, but uyayibona leyo part le. I like what you're saying because you are equipping umuntu right now ukuthi angabi dependent ekusikeni ama validation because uma engayitholanga uyalimala.
Exactly.
You know.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. And at any point in any relationship, whether it's work relationship or whatever relationship, pain should not be your portion. The minute you're in a relationship and you're always feeling pain, run. Actually, there was a lady okhulumile izolo nonkulu. I was so touched by story sakhe because the minute she saw something being a hambi kahle, as much as bekumnandi emshadweni wakhe, the money was there, but she just chose to go and go back home. Because sometimes we compromise and stay sithayi kuzolunga. Funa singayivumeli pain because we even teaching ingane zethu or even people around us ukuthi ipain iright. And if it's painful, yisho, it's either report ekhaya noma seek a psychologist and get yourself help.
It's powerful what you're saying, yes. Because at times ngizwa abantu bethamba ukukhuluma naye lo muntu lo, you know.
Whoa.
And I'm not saying ukuthi wrong. I'm personally a person okwazi ukapproach umuntu, but there are people abakufaka kwi pain deliberately. And when you go to tell them ukuthi right now I'm feeling pain because of you, and I'm not sure how that works out. Angisho ukuthi abantu abangenzi. There are people who can do it, but kwesinye isikhathi the person is deliberate about making you feel the pain. And ugiyomtshena futhi abanye bazothi weak, you know,
exactly. You know. Yes. Actually, in my previous employment, boss yami yasho njalo ngitshela ukuthi yazi uma ukhuluma nami kanje ngiphathisa ngisizo. Yathi, no, you are very weak. So manje ufuna ngibe nenkinga zakho zokuthi wena makukhuluma na ukhuluma kanjani nomuntu umthethise in a work environment. So
yeah, I know some people do that.
Yeah, wangitshela on my face ukuthi uyazi ukuthini wena ukuthi weak. And take care of yourself. It's prioritize rest and prioritize yourself as well. And when going through all these things, remember what you matter to your family. And seek help, as I said earlier, makudingeka ama coping skills ukuthi cope kanjani in that environment. And sometimes kuba ngcono ma into uzoyisa kumuntu ozoyibuka at another angle. Mina that's what helped me. Mangiya ku psychologist ngichazela yonke into. She just looked at me and said, Nompilo uhlale kanjani all these years with all these problems? Ungaphumeli ngani phandle? Uthola usizo lokuthi ukhupha kanjani with this, because this is not acceptable. Omunye umuntu akufanele athithe omunye umuntu kanje. And enye into othulane buyishaye with emsebenzini ukuthi sigcina sishare yonke into nabantu angafanele sishare nabo yonke into. Like we share, yabonje mina my boss knew ukuthi ngakhula kanjani. Uma wami wayigula kanjani, you know, yonke leyo nto sometimes masibuya ayibuyi kahle kumina, kuba sengathi oh vele uma wakho ngoba vele wayene bipolar mhlambe nawo nalezo inkinga yabo, you seeing things engekho, you know.
Do you get a glimpse though why we do that?
Ukuthi singashare
sishare nabantu.
It's because the relationship suke right, suke sifuna bas understand who
we
are.
That's powerful.
It's so sifuna ukuthi baba feel our pain and whatever.
Yes.
But sometimes we shouldn't do that. Yeah. We should be careful. Sifudwebula yini ukuthi okay, I'm going to share a little bit of this, but not everything.
Yeah.
But sometimes you share ngoba ufuna isikhathi off to go home be with your mom attend to your mom's medical what.
Yeah.
But sometimes it's used against
exactly.
you.
Exactly. And ingathi obviously I'm not a psychologist, but ingathi inakho kuba rooted lapho yokufuna ukuzwelwa ukuthi yazothini. Hopefully lo muntu njobe ngihlupa mangimtshena lezi zinto uzoba nakho understand ukuthi bese sengivese nginenkinga ebese uthola ukuthi ke that gets used against you. Uma usebenza nabantu abakanjalo le ndaba okudwebula yini ukuthi wazi ukuthi yazothini, this person I pray for them, but they mean to destroy me. So I really need to be careful what I share with them and all that. Let us have a work relationship nabo. Akuba ukuthi unginikeza umsebenzi ngiyawenza ngibuyisela kuyena.
Yes.
Akufanele ngimtshene ukuthi ngiphekeni nge-weekend. Akufanele ngimtshene ukuthi ade ngenzani. Because labo bantu, they have this thing. I've seen them. I've worked with them. They have i-hunger. Block them on Facebook, block them on status, abanga view iluto yakho, because they want to know each and everything that is happening in your life. Exactly. You know,
kungcono uma una something personal o attendayo unga disclose uvele uthi nje I'm attending something personal, apply leave uhambe.
And
masubuye subuze ukuthiwa bekuyini le, it was personal.
Yes,
that's safer.
And even a simple thing like uk apply leave, abantu abaningi will know this. Notice ngokuthi njalo umuye living umphathi wakhe afuna ukwazi ukuthi uyokwenzani ube uye living onegunya layo as umsebenzi afune nje ukwazi ukuthi kwenzakaleni yabo, afuna ukwazi ngiphathina wakhe, afuna ukwazi ngeingane zakho. There are people who do that sincerely because they want to build the relationship with back understand outside the workplace, but abanye they do that because it gives them this thing ukuthi bubu ngathi ba controller, you know.
No, thank you so much for this. I've actually learned on building good corporate relationships as well. Kui career acceleration program that I'm attending. So let's develop ourselves. Draw the right boundaries to build the right relationships the right way.
No. Sisi, siyaqoqela lana. Ngicabanga ukuthi sizo obviously so qhubeka sibe nawo ama sessions akanje because these are things ezenzekalayo, so kunzima ukuyisamapha nje kuma episode awu 2 or you know. Definitely, we will now and then have these discussions. Now, let's conclude. This thing of leaving your house, going to a place abusive. How do you prepare yourself mentally? What is it that you do every morning? You leaving your house. We are going to workplace. La obona kono kutiazutin. Hey, you know. I remember morning meme. Ekukhona i-building yayisha, you know, like a building in Ngonga. Ukubhale ukuthi hey, this is what I wish to find every time I go to work. Ngathi bangifika emsebenzini, you know, ukuthi ngafika nje kuthiwa hayi godukani namhlanje asisebenzi, you know. And that is being in an abusive place ukuthi you know ukuthi this is where God is using that place to provide you for imali and stuff, but you will wish the worst for your company because you feel like, hey, just ngingasebenzi nje ngihlale phansi ekhaya, you know, lo tele.
Uyakhumbula nami ngisasebenza lapha kule ndawo, ngangiphathwa i-stress mangidlula khona nge-weekend, because this drive around another route ukuze singadluli khona, because wow. So, but I used to pray every morning,
yeah.
Nkosi, protect me.
Sure.
Protect me. Ngimind nokuthi ngithini ngingasho into engafanele ngisho, because as abanye abantu bagcina bebashaya abaphathi babo khona wakambamba nge
amawashingi and into equbuka unganakile. And just on that, sorry to cut ukuhlala eMadevin angekho, khona umuntu wayenconywe ngeke ngasebenza naye kuthiwa u strong lo muntu usebenza nebhubesi kodwa, you know, she's able to handle herself, you know, impressed. And I was concerned ngoba nami I was going through my own things, you know. Uthola ukuthi mfethu uzothi yabuka ngabo 9 lo muntu sase office, yabo
ebusuku.
Yeah,
sure.
Obviously nami I was going through my own things, of which I was doing imsebenzi yabantu, I think about 3 or so. But yena wayesebenza nebhubesi, so and wayenconywe ngimdabukela because ngangiyibuka le nto ukuthi lo muntu lona mfethu ngihleze ngimbona usebenza till that late. Engelinye ilanga wathi kwadideka wonke umuntu fethu ukuthi hawu lo muntu fethu ohleze quiet, soft tone and stuff, you know. Kanti khona into elodigcwala iyafila, akanakile nabantu abanakile. Engelinye ilanga wasnapha against leli bhubesi leli and she dropped down ama files wahamba. She never looked back, you know.
Enough was enough,
yeah.
You know, khona iculo arkelethi when a woman's fed up.
Yeah.
I think we all get to that point where we are like really fed up.
Yeah.
But we shouldn't even allow ourselves to get to that point. Khona ukuthi my khala ubone ukuthi no, this is not for me anymore. Seek help.
Uzokwenza izinto ongakazwa,
ucabanga ukuthi ungazenza.
Ungashisa nenkaphana futhi. You can do the hey, ungenza into ongakazi wacabanga ukuthi ungayenza ngenxa yelodi iqhubeke, you know.
Exactly. Build up.
So just on that, Nompilo, there's this thing that women do that I think I really like. It's just that we can't do it as men. Not can't, but a lot of us really, really struggle. I've noticed that a lot of women, even emsebenzini, when things get tough, they are able to go to a bathroom, afika khale, awashubusa, abuyele emsebenzini ayosebenza.
And
guys mfethu, hey, I've never heard of a guy who does that. I'm not saying ukuthi abekho. Ma ukuthi ukhona ntanga wenza leyo nto, angifuni kube ngathi ku yet, you know. But you know, hey, you know, yeah.
Yeah. Mina ngangiyenza kakhulu leyo, and it worked for me. Ukuthi ngibone ukuthi okay, lo muntu usefe wangithethe isicamsi ngizokhala lapha ngakho, kuvele ngehle ngezantsi, ngifike ngikhale ngithandaze, ngilungise kahle bese ngibuyele office ngi-right. Abantu bathi kwenza kanjani lokho ngoba kade simbone nje. Abanye abantu banesibindi sobuthi bayabaphathi bafanele bamemeze ema passageini. Uyabo manje kube i-office lonke elibonayo ukuthi hayi bokushuthi udiniwe umphathi kalo. So ukuye bathroom nje ufika ukhale uthandaze uphindele back.
Yeah.
Mina nje angikaze ngikhale phambi kwamphathi wami noma wangihlupha kanjani. It was only that once lapho ngamconfronta khona ukuthi yazi uma ukhuluma ngaleli tone leno ngiphathisa ngesizwe. Wangitshela ukuthi ngiweke. Emva kwalokho ngathi wayisazi naye ukuthi ngistrong because ngiwangakaze angibone nje ngicomplainer. Ngangiqhubeka nempilo nje ngazi ukuthi ngizele ngizokwenza and ngizokwenza kahle.
But just on that, but bengingafuni focus kube kakhulu kule relationship yakho nalowo muntu lo. But iyangiqeda le ukuthi and I'm saying this because ngifuna abantu balalele ukuthi we are not only talking to laba abahlukumezekayo, ngikhuluma futhi nabantu mhlawumbe ongenzeka ukuthi bakuma positions of power.
Hey,
engiqeda lento ukuthi the same person fethu owayekwazi ukufika akhluphe kanjena aphinde akwazi ukuthi ibhosi yakhe nesimnikeza inkinga abe ntekenteke ngalendlela ukuthi akubize office lakhe azokhalela wena akutshena ukuthi usebenza ngaphansi kwebhosi ebhlungu emphatha kabhlungu angabe sayibona ukuthi lento ayichaza nale bhosi yona into ayiyona kuwe you know
yeah I think Dennis would say it's human nature
yeah
kushuthi umuntu into ayifilayo yena kaboni masenza abanye abantu bayifile ufuna wena umdabukele masezimkhalela kodwa wena masekhlupa akanandaba ukuthi kwenzakalani
sure
it's a sad fact
yeah no Nompilo mfethu siyabonga I think this was a bit faster in terms of discussion it was full of ilendo because yeah I think we needed an hour to maybe have this and stuff you know but yeah thank you so much mfethu mhlape nje so conclude mfethu anything you'd like to add anything that is in your heart especially with regards to your workplace right now there's someone mfethu who's going through something you know maybe let me say this first ngibonga ukuthi you know I've seen mfethu again I think it's highlighted lento kule episode it becomes a challenge when you are sure ukuthi blessing yakho izoba kuleyo ndawo through that person you know I abuse enkulu even right now esemasontweni ile ndaba leyo ukuthi abantu bay elevate kuma positions to a point ukuthi I blessing yakho ilele kubona ngeke uze uye kwenye indawo ufike uphumelele ngale ukuthi mina ngi release I blessing over impilo yakho I'm not saying ukuthi abantu abangay understand the authority nokuthi abantu ba uNkulunkulu babeke kuma positions of influence for a reason but lento le yokuthi umuntu akulimite when you are in their midst and you feel like there's nothing you can do without them anything ufuna ukuyenza kufanele ifakwe istamp kubona right now there's someone who's going through something the reason why I'm saying this is because it mina ngazi kahle kamhlophe ukuthi uma ngithatha izinto as a training ground you know I ground otrainela kulona ne ground odlalela kulona awavamile ukuthi afane you know I ground ozotraina kulona lizothi kuba rafanyana but to have that in mind ukuthi yes whatever that I'm going through is not pleasing but there is a place where God is calling me you know
yeah I think in my conclusion is God is calling us to a higher place
let
us not limit ourselves with this into sibonayo manje sky is the limit mhlambe ngoba kule yonkampani awuzili kuzochitha khona mhlambe ugcina usune nkampani yakho enkulu noma ugcina usenza something that is in your heart your passion will just bloom you know so I think as focus on my passions as well empower ourselves and train ourselves outside of work because there's a lot more we can do outside of work like for you for instance umbhali kodwa uyakwazi ukuba ku corporate as well so let us not look as corporate as the main blessing yabona nje nami I'm an entrepreneur at heart so ngiyabona manje ukuthi as much as ngisebenza but I can also do this on a full time basis so there's a lot in us it's not just that office ukuthi kufanele kuzufele khona kufanele kube ne service ya 30 years or anything if uzinto zingahambi kahle start looking around uNkulunkulu will open doors for you yazi mina God umsebenzi 5 minutes away from where I was working but I didn't even know that company existed but when it happened it was just a wow moment
this is amazing
and they actually interviewed me in 2 hours ngathola impendulo ukuthi bangithathile ne offer letter was ready and it was the last day of August and ngangathi ngitshela ukuthi whether ngiyawuthola umsebenzi or not
ngifuna ukuhamba
and I used to come back home crying every day and uNkulunkulu made a way so uNkulunkulu is able to make a way
there's power mfethu in what you've said You didn't know the company existed. Company was just 5 minutes next to you.
Exactly. You know? I didn't know. Ngangazi ngiyibona nokuyibona ngidlule emgwaqeni.
That thing mfethu, I think we umlaleli uzoyicubungula ngendlela ehlukahlukene. Because right we tend to have ama superheroes, people who will come and save us in our minds. We have industries and organizations that we think are going to be able to help us, you know. Abanye mfethu mhlambe solution yakho nje izoba kutheni uqoqoqododi mhlawumbe uhlala endaweni enenkinga yododi mhlawumbe ungaqala inkampani yokuqoqododi mfethu mhlawumbe the solution is just next to you
but you never saw it the same way
you know and at times umuhlukumezeka ubona ngathi hayi vese ayikho enye indawo engaya kuyo this is the only place I can be you know and then you realize uthi hayibo kanti umhlaba omkhulu kangaka you know so I think that is very powerful mfethu but God is involved, Bafethu. God is in charge. I just want to echo that even as we close the session.
Can I just add one?
Yeah, no, definitely.
So there's a lady that I met izolo. Ukhuluma ngokuthi wayeke emsebenzini because ubusumstressa kakhulu umsebenzi. And then masekile emsebenzini sekubona basemsebenzini wakhe abafikayo bathi sicela usizo vele uvule icompany sokunikeza umsebenzi usebenze as a company yourself.
Yeah.
And I'm like, buka kwenze kahle wayeke ngoba kuba uyeka ngizoqhubeka uhlukumezeke. So we must be mindful of what we're feeling and we must be true to ourselves, we must be authentic in everything that we do.
Yeah. And just on that, mfethu, enye into engifuna ukisho because enye into with God, you never know what God is going to do. There was a time that I was sure I'm leaving and I need to be out of here. And uNkulunkulu mfethu wangiblessa the same place.
Yeah, you know. Yeah.
So whoever is listening, we are not drafting a path yakho ukuthi this is how it will happen.
Exactly.
You have to leave the organization.
Exactly.
Abanye abantu will become managers, executive people, same organizations where they were feeling like it was over.
Yeah.
You know, bebe abusekile. UNkulunkulu akusebenzise the same place, you know. Utavete didn't need to ukuthi ayoba inkosi kwesinye isizwe noma ayoba uNkulunkulu wasebenzisa the very same throne eyayimnikeza inkinga ukuthi arise ayohlala kuyo le throne ka Saul ayimnikeza inkinga. So open your mind and pray and just seek God. Asazi ukuthi impumelelo yakho noma breakthrough yakho izophuma phi, you know. Enye into engiyibukile ukade ngikhona iclass engilibukayo le masterclass uSamuel L. Jackson ukhuluma ukhuluma ngeacting. Uthi uma ekhuluma khona uthi we said respect everyone, respect umuntu obambe camera, respect umuntu obambe light. Uthi right now I'm the biggest actor mfethu in the world, but guess what, I'm being employed by abantu ababe bamba ama camera na ma light ngi-actor mina. Abanye babe wama administration, you know, bebe wama PA. Uthi right now they call me ukuthi when I was a PA, when you treated me well, namhlanje I'm a producer, ngicela uzosebenza kule movie. Uthi it's an amazing thing ever. Never be big, you know. Always be humble and, you know, you'll never know, you know, ukuthi ubani ozokunikeza opportunity ngelinye ilanga.
Definitely,
you know. Lo muntu ombona eShanel eKoropa ngelinye ilanga mfethu uzokulinka ne-CEO because I said it in the past. These people esibabuye kancane ma-organizations, ibona abakwazi ukungena kwi-office le-CEO ingafune muntu angene. Angene kodwa yena. I-CEO ibhodloke, ibhoboke kuyena, imtshene ngey'nkinga abhekene nazo. Ngelinye ilanga, labo bantu laba bozwa inkinga ungalethi isixazululo sayo wena. Athi awuyazi khona umfana engimaziyo kanje kanje.
It's
why bomletheni. Like it happened for Saul. Enenkinga kuthi hayi khona umfana okwazi ukudlala into kanje kuthi wamletheni. Ungayithathi kancane izinto uNkulunkulu akugrant ezona. Respect people and continue to work on that.
That's so profound.
You know?
Yeah. Nami ngisho njalo nje, respect is. Mina yazi ngiyumngani nabantu abakinayo emsebenzini. And it does a whole lot of good for me, even also it's about my security.
Yeah.
Like told umuntu in my previous employment ngase ngikhulekelwa yibona ngoba ibona babebona ukuthi hayi uNompilo
ukudlula
kanjani kule nto le ibona inkinga yakho masivela ngisho.
So
kufuneka sihloniphe abantu ukuthi bayini akuyona indaba yethu leyo, thina sihlonipha nje wonke umuntu esihlangana naye ngoba umuntu kaNkulunkulu and you never know ukuthi uzokusiza ngani ngempela lowo muntu in the future. Like kulo msebenzi engikubona njengamanje khona enye training njengiyibonile ngathi oh wow, this would be nice for executive coaching. Mangithi ngithola i-email umphathi wami uthi you attending this training bese ngisaba ngisho ukucela izinto manje kanti uNkulunkulu has put me in another place.
Yeah, la ungakwazi ukucela.
Exactly.
And makuthiwa no futhi kungabe ukuthi uno
obunenkinga.
Exactly.
Yebona kuba ukuthi uno because uno but yeah, ku possible ukuthi ungahlukumezeka lapho khona but uNkulunkulu i-future yakho isezandleni zaNkulunkulu. Ungakwazi ukuthi akulifted in another place engcono kunale kuyona njengamanje. So asimthembe sibe real, sibe authentic with regards to our feelings. Makubhlungu kubhlungu asithola abantu abazosisiza. Bese siya excel.
Thank you so much Mpelo, we will have more of these discussions and mfethu asikhulumi kanjena ngoba singama expert but we believe ukuthi in sharing our stories, in sharing what we've seen, in sharing what God is doing empilweni zethu, kuyakwazi ukuguguzela omunye umuntu olalele. I think that's all is needed. I think nathi whenever we were kulezinto endawo sasikuzo, we were needing people nje abazokwazi ukushare their own lives and basiguguzele. I hope uyaguguzeleka mfethu, and if you know umuntu oyidingayo le message, share mfethu, umsendele link, you know, just listen to it mfethu. Grow yourself like Nompilo was saying. Ngena ku YouTube, you know. Yazi mfethu, ngena ku LinkedIn, you know, ngena ku LinkedIn, research izinto mfethu, bheka ama positions, bheka ukuthi abantu benzani, grow yourself.
Yeah.
Ikhathi siqeda ku Facebook na ku WhatsApp, angisho ukuthi ngithini, kodwa let us try and use, take some of the time sifake entweni ezosikhulisa zisakhe. Like I always say when I end the show, God is love.
Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. There's still going to be lots and lots and lots of good content. Thank you so much for tuning in.
Thank you so much. God is love, Nompilo. Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Bye.